Hello and welcome to the city of Lucknow, the capital and largest city in the state of Uttar Pradesh. It's a city known as one of the cultural capitals of North India, a tourist destination and a gourmet's delight. It is also the city where one of India's most talented badminton players, Syed Moldy, was tragically shot and killed in 1988. This tournament, the Syed Moldy International, is played in memory of the 1982 Commonwealth Games gold medalist. And this year, it is the second event on the 14 tournament BWF Grand Prix Gold Series. The Grand Prix Gold, of course, is the tier of tournaments just below the Super Series. And as with last year, we have 14 Grand Prix Gold events. Last week, the very first was in Cebu in Malaysia. And what an event that was. For only the seventh time in Grand Prix Gold history, all five titles went to players from five different nations. There we are. We can see that the Syed Moldy Grand Prix Gold, the second on the list of 14. A couple of changes to this year's Grand Prix Gold calendar. New Zealand moves from March to August, and Thailand has new dates in early June. Two of those tournaments have been part of the Grand Prix Gold since the inception of the Grand Prix Gold in 2007. So Chinese Taipei and Macau, those two tournaments from the very start this year, will host an 11th consecutive Grand Prix Gold. Well, as far as this tournament is concerned, the Syed Moldy International, well, this started in 2011 as part of the Grand Prix Gold, so this is the sixth edition, and if you think my maths is wrong, that's because there was no tournament in 2013. Well, it is semi-finals day today, and five semi-finals for you this afternoon. And four of those five semi-finals feature players who have an Olympic medal. What a terrific lineup. We're starting with women's doubles, and we've got the Olympic silver medalists from Rio last year, Kamilla Juhl and Christinna Pedersen, up against the Malaysian pair, Lim Yin Lu and Yap Cheng Wen, in only their seventh tournament together, and this is their seventh semi-final. That's an incredible start to a partnership. Then it's men's doubles, and Lu Qing Yao and Yang Po Han of Chinese Taipei. They're a left and right-handed combination, as indeed both of the women's doubles pairs in our first match. They're up against the winners from last week in the second match, that men's doubles, and of course that was Beri Anggriawan and Hardianto of Indonesia. Then we'll have the second of the men's doubles and the former champions of this event. They won the tournament here 2 years ago, Matthias Bohr and Carsten Morgensen. They were silver medalists from the 2012 Olympic Games. They are the former world number ones. They're up against more Indonesian opposition, Alfian and Ardianto. Then we'll have mixed doubles, and the two women on court in that mixed doubles will be playing their second match of the day because they're both in women's doubles, Pedersen and Ashwini Ponapa. But as far as the mixed doubles is concerned, well, the Danes, Fischer Nielsen and Pedersen, they were Olympic bronze medalists in 2012. They're former world number ones. And they're up against this new Indian pair. They're only in their second ever tournament together. Sumith already and Ashwini Ponapa. They too have made a great start to their partnership. Then we finish with women's singles and the darling of Indian sport as far as female athletes is concerned. It's Pusala Venkata Sindhu, the Olympic silver medalist. She's been in the final of this event twice previously. Can she make it three times? She's never won the title here, incidentally. She's up against the 18-year-old Fitriani of Indonesia. So a terrific lineup for you this afternoon at semi-finals day. Well, as far as the women's doubles draw is concerned, well, we have the number one and three seeds at the semi-final stage. At the bottom half of the draw, I can tell you there's no seeds at all. So both seeds in the top half, and that's the match we're going to concentrate on. Kamilla Juhl and Christinna Pedersen up against the number three seeds from Malaysia, Lim Yin Lu and Yap Cheng Wen. So the fans here in Lucknow, well, they've been treated to some great badminton already this week. We've all been treated to some the great badminton. And what a thrill for the home fans that for only the fourth time in the history of the Grand Prix gold, that all four men's singles semi-finalists coming from the host nation. And of course, the previous times that we've had four players in the men's singles semi-finals have all come from the same nation, has twice happened in Indonesia, once in Korea. So the first time that Indian players have filled all semi-final spots. So plenty for the home fans to cheer about as the women's doubles players make their way onto court. So the vastly experienced Danes, Kamilla, Rytter, Juhl and Christinna Pedersen. Both these pairs, as I was saying, comprising of a left and right hander. And it really is a remarkable start to the partnership for the number three seeds from Malaysia. They only formed their partnership last October, at the 2016 Vietnam International Series. They reached the final of that event. So last year, five tournaments for the Malaysian pair and three finals. That's extraordinary, isn't it? So Kamilla Rytter, the tall Dane, born in Skagen, right in the north of North Jutland. She is a former world champion in the mixed doubles discipline. Won the mixed doubles gold medal with Thomas Laybourne at the World Championships here in India, in Hyderabad in 2009. Well, she'll be very happy with that. She's actually 33 years of age, not 23. And she is tall, as you can see. 6 foot tall, the 33-year-old from Skagen. They're currently number two in the world ranking, she and her partner, Christinna Pedersen. She is 30 years of age, and she's not quite as tall as that, I can assure you. She's 178, she's 5 foot 10. Four world championship medals for her, born in Aalborg. And they're actually making their first appearance here at the Syed Modi Grand Prix Gold. So, as far as they're concerned, well, they had a bye in the first round, they had a walkover in the second round, and a walkover in the quarterfinal. Those aren't actually their results. I'm sorry to say, they haven't actually played so far. So into the semi-final without playing any opponents. So as far as the Malaysians are concerned, Lim Yin Lu and Yap Ching Wen. There's Lim Yin Lu, 28 years of age from Saraman. And she and her partner shot up from 47 at the beginning of the week to 39, up 8 places. Rankings republished every Thursday, so they're at a career high in only their 7th tournament together. That really is quite remarkable. So the left-handed Yap Cheng Wen is 22 years of age from Malacca, southwest coast of the Malay Peninsula. Well, as far as they're concerned, yes, they have played two matches, and both of their matches in two straight games. Only 19 minutes for that second round match. They also had a bye in the first round by virtue of their seeded position. So our umpire Kulkarni from India. And so too is our service judge. Well, we only started with four seeds in the women's doubles because we only had 25 pairs in the tournament. And of those 25 pairs, 21 of them were from India. So there weren't only three.
And Pedersen, Christinna,
pairs
Denmark.
From nations other than the host nation.
Lim Yin Lu and Yap Cheng Wen, Malaysia. Yap Cheng Len to serve to Juhl Kamilla Rytter. Low all, play.
So the number three seeds nearest to us from Malaysia up against the Olympic silver medalists Kamilla Juhl and Christinna Pedersen. Yeah, it's a good smash from the 33-year-old across the body. Well, I know the Danes yesterday when they heard that they were going to have a walkover
against
Balan and so on, that they were very disappointed because they haven't actually played a match in this arena and they want to get used to the conditions. Of course, Christinna Pedersen has been busy playing mixed doubles, so she's very aware of the conditions, but the tall left-hander is not. That's a powerful smash, isn't it? Straight down the line and the left-handed. Yap. Cheng Wang committed to the backhand defense.
4-1.
Over
2-4.
Oh, that's clever. That's clever. Well, that's part of the problem with the brand new partnership as Lim and Yap are. Understanding of who goes for what, but quite frankly, that's such a good defensive shot from Christinna Pedersen. I'm not sure many pairs would have got that back. Short. Good rally. Oh, that's landed in. That's a great shot. Yeah.
6-2.
28-year-old Lim Ying Lu. Vastly more experienced than her partner. She's been as high as 21 in the world ranking, playing with Go Liu Ying, who of course was the Olympic silver medalist in the mixed doubles discipline with Chou Pin Soon. There's confusion again between the two Malaysian players. Who's going for that one down the middle?
Over 3-7. Service over 8-3.
Oh, that's a lovely serve. I reckon she's one of the best servers in world badminton.
9-3.
Well, I think the Malaysian pair at the moment got to try and get themselves more on the attack. This is better from them. Got to hit in a downward direction because
service
every time that the tall Danes.
4-9.
Are attacking and they seem to win the rally.
Kick, kick, kick.
Oh, that's landed in. Yeah, there is a little drift in this arena.
5-9.
That looked as if it just held up a little to me. Yeah, it was the call from her partner to leave it. I think the left-hander was going to play it. Yeah, it's the counter-attack that's been so good so far from the Danes. Every time that the Malaysians have hit in a downward direction, as with this one, look at that defensive shot. Flat over the net, aimed towards the tram lines, and it lands past the front court player. But still lands in front of the rear court player, so it's an excellent shot and excellent tactics in all doubles disciplines. So it's a 6-point advantage
at
the mid-game interval here in the opening game. And it's in favour of the three-time European champions. Just 5 minutes into the match to the mid-game interval.
Court one, 20 seconds. Court one, 20 seconds.
Yeah, we've got you. Seeing themselves on the giant screen.
Play.
Oh my goodness, round the back! What a shot from the left-handed Juhl. Oh! And that's well taken too. By the other left-hander on court. My goodness, it was a defensive shot early on. There it is! That's extraordinary. She didn't just get it back, she got it back with interest. Beautiful play. Oh, that's nice. I like that one. Yeah, turn the whole rally around. Change the momentum. Defensive shot from Yap Chen Wen. That one. Beautifully done. Well, I don't know what the Malaysian coach, Wong Pei Ti, said in that quick timeout at the mid-game interval. Well, whatever she said, it's worked.
Service over. 12-7.
Well, I have to say the Malaysians are doing very well about moving Kamilla Juhl from side to side. There's the forehand, then play her to the backhand. Deep in court. I
like
the commitment at the front of the court there from Juhl.
Lim.
But it was good defence from the Malaysians.
Now Lim Yin Lu
is going to be spoken to. Taking too much time in between rallies. I remember she was fourth in the Commonwealth Games in Glasgow in 2014 in the women's doubles playing with Lai Peijing. Lost a thrilling bronze medal playoff match against Gabby Adcock and Lauren Smith. Got cramp in the end. She was taking an age in between rallies because of her cramp. Can't remember which leg it was, but she could hardly walk. Well,
11,
I said that
12.
Malaysian coach had worked wonders in that mid-game interval. Five of the 6 points played since that interval have gone the Malaysians' way. Took it early.
13, 11.
Yeah, in fact, Lim Yin Lu playing her partner into trouble there.
It's okay. I'm here. Yep.
Yeah, no, it should be 13.
13, 11.
13, 10. Yeah, 13-10, I think, not 13-11. Or maybe it is 11. Certainly the scoreboard at the back of the court shows 12-10. Flying a little quicker coming towards us as we look down on the court. So the Danes are going to have to be careful with their lifts from that far side. Nice little push, just get caught with the drift. It's one taken.
Service over. 14. 12.
Yeah, I think that's a risky 15, tactic to take 12. On Christinna Pedersen at the front of the court. And she's enjoyed so much success in mixed doubles, Olympic bronze medalist in 2012 with Jochen Fischer, and we'll see them later on today, is because she's so good on her front court play, reads the game so well. It's another terrific serve, isn't it? Oh, goodness. Oh, you'd never guess it's her first
16,
match this week,
12.
Would you? Rutil, timing that quite beautifully. Very crisp. Thundering that down. Yep.
17.
More power from the tall left-hander.
Thank you. Service over. 13-17. Play.
Oh, they're still in touching distance. Two titles last year, the Indonesian International Challenge and the Scottish Grand Prix. And they're trying to make it through to a first ever Grand Prix gold final, the Malaysian pair. I know she made a mistake, Limian Lu, but the fact that she didn't want to lift it, just trying to guide the shuttle back to the net, I like the thought process, I like the idea.
Over. 14-18.
I think that's the first service error of the match, isn't it? Well, the Danes under a lot more pressure now, and that's because of the Malaysians' good play. Just 2 points the deficit now. Balance when 18. She played that smash. More probability, that's why she made the error. So just 1 point in it now. Oh, that's desperately
18
flat.
All.
Must have missed time that. It was me a moment ago saying she was timing the shuttle well. So back level. 18 all.
Service over. 19-18.
Well, I'm a little surprised that the umpire is allowing the Danes to towel down at this stage of a game.
No water break. Yep. No water break. Lim. On court.
Well, the umpire saying to the Malaysian players, no water break. Well, Danes certainly had a water break. Nice idea, 20, wrong execution. There, she knows it. Look of anguish from Limian Lu.
Blake.
So game point opportunities for the number one seeds.
Service over.
Service
19-20.
From Pedersen. One service error apiece from the two Danes.
Lim, play.
That's good placement of the smash. And Juhl trying another bit of trickery. This time it didn't work. Tried between the legs. So 20 all means that we will require extra points until there's a clear 2-point winning margin. Well, quite frankly, at 3-9 down in this opening game, I didn't give the Malaysians any chance. All credit to them. They've never stopped fighting. A lot of flick serves from them, though. It's gone wide. So will it be third time lucky as far as the Danes are concerned? And this a third game point opportunity. Yeah, it's aimed towards that forehand side of the left-hander. Very, very difficult to control the defence. Backhand defence is technically much easier than forehand defence. And the Danish coach, Thomas Stangl. Much the longest rally of this opening game as well, I suspect. Oh, the dive! She got back up. Oh, that's brilliant!
Service over. 21 all.
That is extraordinary rally. The Danes were on the attack for so long. And then when they were forced to defend, well, it needed a dive to the little block. Got up again quickly, but in the end, to no avail. What a rally.
On court.
I could only see the Malaysian coach. I'm behind where she's sitting, and that's not Wong Pei Ti. I do apologise. So, 21 all. Good flick serve. Oh, it's called out! That can't have been out by much, my 21. Goodness. Oh, that goes down as a service error. And it's a fourth game point opportunity for the Danes. this time they convert. And I think they were a little bit fortunate. Yes, the smile from Juhl confirms my theory. I suspect that a push down the forehand side, the right-hand side of the court as we look down, may have been going wide, but it was taken nonetheless. This one. Yeah, I think that may have been going out, but that's all academic now. Lim Yin Lu chose to play the shot. Keep the rally going. And it's game over. Game in favour of the number one seeds. But my goodness, they had to work hard for it. 23-21. Opening game in a little over 25 minutes. Well, a very good opening game it was. After perhaps not the best of starts by the Malaysians, my goodness, they came back strongly, didn't they? Five tournaments last year, two semi-finals, one beaten finalist spot and two titles. Played last week in their home events, the Malaysian Masters Grand Prix Gold in Cebu. And they reached the semi-final there as well.
Court one, 20 seconds.
So, having secured the opening game, the number one seeds, 23-21. Get this second game underway. Yeah, that's stayed in. No question about the drift in this arena. Great attacking play. My goodness me, athletic ability there of Lim Yin Lu. One. Well, there had been one before that. I think that was at least three smashes. That great angle on the final one. And a good elevation as well on the jump.
Service over. 2-1.
Oh, I like that smash. She's an active player. Yep, Cheng Wen. Oh, that's brilliant.
Service over. Two.
Well, off. There's no challenge system here. Pedersen automatically calling for a challenge. I thought it was on the line. Yeah. Good call, line judge. I agree.
Great. Yindusa.
It was the variation in attacking play and angle, pace of shot. That's what I particularly liked about it, but I did think it was plumb on the line. Oh! Yeah, indecision. The back of the court and the indecision costing her dear. Well judged, my goodness.
Service over.
Such a
three all.
A sitter, as we call it. When an easy opportunity, I think I would have been tempted to play that. I'm really sure it was going wide, and she was absolutely right about that. I don't believe it. I don't believe it. How on earth did she get that back? Well, that's a pity that her partner then made an error on the smash. That was extraordinary get by Christinna Pedersen. The shuttle had been deflected by hitting the top of the tape, and she readjusted her shot, that one, and still controlled it quite beautifully. That's amazing.
Five,
three. No service short.
Four,
that's a second service error. Well, I had a little think about
service
it.
Over.
That shuttle sat on
six,
the top of the
four.
Tape. That fell back the Danish side. Crikey, that was close, wasn't it?
Play. Seven, four.
Six of the last 8 points to the Malaysian pair.
Point.
Oh, yes.
Service over. 5-7.
That's the combination play with the left and right hander. Placement of the smash straight down the line. Expecting the straight block, and that's coming up to the left-hander's forehand side.
Four. Six, seven.
Oh, I think she was right to go for it. Yep, Cheng Wen.
Yes.
You've got to take half chances. You've got to try and put pressure on your opponents. And even if you make some mistakes, the sheer threat of intercepting at the net is worth several points per game. Yeah. Good work.
Seven all.
Yeah, he wants them hitting in a downward direction. He probably wants some more angle from them as well, rather than just
play.
Same pace.
Seven all. Yep, it will.
Yeah, seven all. I can tell you the scoreboards around the court have got the wrong score, which is why the players just asked the umpire to confirm. going wide. So back into the leads.
Seven.
Scoreboard in the arena still wrong. Yeah, they seem quite content to keep Kamilla Juhl at the back of the court. Malaysians making her work, yeah, and then enjoying success with it too at the moment.
Service over, 9-8. In.
Oh, I like that. Good rally. Oh, unbelievable. This is fabulous. Yeah, the change of pace from Lim Yin Lu doing the damage in the end. And I have to say, the more I watch Yap Cheng Wen, the more impressed I am. She is a busy player. I know I said that in the opening game, but it's the first time I've really had the privilege of watching her. She only turned 22 earlier this month. She's not the tallest of athletes, 156, that's about 5'5". But the little left-hander, what she lacks in height, she makes up for with enthusiasm. So psychologically, I always think it's very important for players or pairs to have the advantage at the mid-game interval. Oh.
10,
what
9.
On earth was happening there with the Danes? Great defence, but surely Pedersen should have gone for that. No, she was going to cover the whip down her partner's backhand side. Clever play by the Malaysians. Oops, my goodness gracious. That's
11,
wild
interval
from Kamilla Juhl. So it is the Malaysians who have the advantage at the mid-game interval here in game number two. In contrast to the opening game when it was the Danes who had a 6-point advantage.
Court one, 20 seconds. Court one, 20 seconds.
Lim on court. Juhl on court.
Nine, play. Service over. 10,
yeah,
11.
I wonder if that's been a deliberate tactic from the coach, Thomas Stangor. There weren't, up until then, very many deep pushes off the return of the low serve. Back level. It's another flick serve. Oh yes, really, really pressurizing. Yap Cheng went. Yeah, he liked that, didn't he? I bet that's one of his tactical advices as well. 1-2. And I think there'd been one prior to that as well. Down a forehand side, then towards right hip, which for the left-hander is a perfect placement of the attacking shot. She's going to be spoken to here.
Yin Lu Lim, warning for misconduct.
Well, warning for misconduct, and the misconduct, I believe, is taking too much time in between rallies. She has been warned about it earlier on. That's fair by the umpire. If you give a verbal warning and the player continues, it should be a yellow card. Five straight points since the mid-game interval.
Play.
And this time, I'd love to know what the Danish coach has said. I wanted to know what she had said in the mid-game interval of the opening game, because whatever she said to the Malaysian pair worked wonders. Now the opposite is true, with the Danes having found some good tactics. Yeah, good judgment.
14-11.
Six straight points. Yeah, I suspect that's the drift coming into play. That's a beautiful low serve, isn't it? Yeah. Stepped into
16,
the defence. Juhl. Well, run continues. Seven straight points now. Look at that defence. Oh, strings have gone in Juhl's racket. Oh, that was a little bit fortunate for the Danes. Got the lucky net cord, because in essence they only have one player on court who could play the shuttle.
You can have a quick towel, but no drink.
The strings towel. Went. Yeah, she knew it immediately too. 8 straight points. Yeah. Oh, this is amazing. I wonder if they can go from 9-11 down at the mid-game interval, whether they can win 11 straight points to close out this match, this semi-final. Oh, well, that's probably the kiss of death now I've said that, isn't it? She has reason to look concerned. I don't think that it's necessarily that the Malaysians have done anything wrong. I just think the Danes have picked up their game, played with more intensity, good attacking badminton.
19-11.
Ten straight points. Oh. No. Gone wide, and therefore the run comes to an end.
12-19.
But I think that run is probably decisive. But you never know. That's what's so thrilling about sport, isn't it? You just never know. Oh, I know, that's a jolly good smash. Good angle, good power, good placement. And 8 match point opportunities. Look at this. Across the defence of the left-hander. Still match points for the Danes. Oh, that's brilliant. What great defense.
14-20.
Well, the Danes have only been in 3 previous Grand Prix Gold Tournament finals. And the 3 previous they were in, they won them all. So looking to reach a 4th Grand Prix Gold final. And this time they do. They convert. 23-21, 21-14 in a match just under the 50-minute mark. Well, from the mid-game interval of the second game, they really did accelerate away. And their confirmation, number one seeds, Kamilla, Juhl and Christinna Pedersen. Safely through to the final. 23-21, 21-14. So the Danes take leave of the courts. And that means that our first of our semi-finals from Lucknow in Uttar Pradesh has been won by Kamilla and Christinna Pedersen. As you can see, two close games, just under 50 minutes for that. Next up is the two men's doubles. The winners from last week, Angriawan and Hardianto, up against Lu and Yang from Chinese Taipei. Then it's the former champions, Bo and Mogerson. They are very popular here in India. So the fans will be anxious to see them.